Hello everyone, I'm your host, Boss Zombie. Welcome back to Metro Exodus. I'm just gonna be turning off these lights, this tunnel. And now, were those paintings on the cave walls a sign from them not to go in? Like, they consider this a bad place? Also, it hasn't checkpointed me in a while, and that's kind of... There you are. I knew I could count on you, checkpoint system. Night vision. What the fuck? Was that someone shot someone? Pirate. What was that about? Oh, a little boat. Oh, a little note. On the lower farm, 30 bandits. I've been leading them from the road. Half an hour, losing too much blood. Oh. Little one. It's not really a little one. Where am I in relation? Well, help if I can read what I'm looking at. Where the fuck did I just come out? This is not where I was expecting the tunnel to go. Maybe I should have stayed on that pathway in the canyon? Bandits? I can kill bandits! Oh, why do I not have any... Bolts. Okay, I don't need to craft any bolts, though. Should I put a red dot on this? No, I don't think I need to because that might give me away. Let's make another med kit just to have it. And I want some knives. You're not important people. I can throw knives at you. Well, they might have guns. That guy looks dead. Oh, I could have gotten knives here. Okay, I got a revolver now at least. So I guess I don't have my weapons anymore. Can I not free this guy? Okay. Wait. Oh, this takes the spot of a sniper rifle. Well, isn't that interesting? Maybe going that way? Okay. Oh, good. I went from a forest camp to a bandit camp. Excellent. Right? These are bandits, right? Oh. Me like you, the crossbow. Oh, I hope that was a bandit and not a good person. No, they don't have crossbows. They must be bandits. What? New objective? Oh no, just telling me bandit camp. Okay, should be able to just sneak right out by, right? Maybe not. Let's see, can I just get it over here and jump the fence? Do I want to jump the fence? They said something about the church. Okay, so I think this is a place the bandits took over. Okay, so I need to get to the church on the hill. What's the range on this? Not on a crossbow, I wonder. Pretty good! I wonder how pretty good, though. Wait, you had two guns? What a spoiled person you were. Okay, I'm not gonna bother with that guy. Except I might have to. Alright. You're dead. Oh, shit. Tell me no one heard that. Got this silent. Wow, you really didn't hear that, huh? Uh-oh. There's a light in there that I didn't think was in there. Let's see if I can get a good angle. Shit. You don't know where I was. Oh, come on. Shit. Firefight is not what I wanted. Reloaded. It's just where are they? Wait, did I kill him? No one's on alert, and the music stopped. I don't think I killed him. Oh yeah, I did. I was lucky. That could have gone way worse. I just hope no one comes up this way, like this man is doing. You come up this way, I'm gonna snipe you in the head. Oh, there's two of them, huh? Maybe I won't. How did I get up there, though, to the church level? Okay, they're still saying they haven't found me yet. That's fine. That's fine. Should I keep going this way? Nobody sees me. Somehow they didn't see me at all. I was lucky. Is this a dead end? Did I do this for nothing? Oh, where does this canyon go? Where am I going? Oh, this goes higher up. This might be where I needed to go. And a checkpoint. Hey, I made it through that camp pretty swell, huh? They're still looking for me down there. I won't have a problem up here, right? Why did you give me Molotovs? Why does this look like an arena? No, not an arena? Okay, that's fine. These are tombstones, I imagine. Oh, this does look like an arena. Ooh. Well, there's been a bear, and now there's a big open arena. What was that? Oh, never mind. Just like a weird sheet or something. I don't like this. Is that a person that's dead on the floor there? Oh, you're... Oh no, that's just your weird skull mask. It's not actual. Yeah, this is a proper graveyard. Can I even... Are these doors? Can I open this? He's coming with a flashlight. And another Molotov. Oh, why are you giving me so many of these? Seriously, what do I... How do I get in here? What am I... Oh, it's a ladder. Hi. Hi. Artyom, you can get with snipping that ladder. Oh, that's why you gave me these. Oh, we can run through the stone. Do we need to cut this while it's distracted? Oh, I do. Oh, I do. Oh, climb. Oh, climb. Oh, okay. That worked out. Haha. Haha. That's what you get, bear. And I'm back up to Molotovs. Right? Yeah. Well, that wasn't so bad. That's definitely not the last I'll see that bear.
How you doing? What is your situation? Over.
How is it going?
Anna, please.
Oh, this is a lovely... Oh, this is a workbench? Workbench. So, do I not have my gun? No, I guess I don't. What is this now? Oh, If this is my new gun, I might as well clean it. How about this boy? This boy's clean too. Yeah, we gotta get rid of that scope. Or maybe not, actually. That guy. No, you know what? I'm gonna keep scope on that, and then this guy's, or the, this one's gonna have the 4x scope. Yeah. Explosive bolts. Oh, they're really cheap to make too. I don't have a T-car right now, so I guess that's pretty good, right? Need much else. Ooh, tape player. And junk. Play the tape. Why is this? Okay, I guess I'll just turn on the generator that has no fuel. Ain't that how it always goes? What are the odds? Nope. Oh, wait. Never mind. That's a weird... Why would they do that? Why wasn't it on to begin with? What is this thing? Oh, it's just a light. Did I need that to open this door? Oh!
Freeze, Drifter! So, we meet again?
Oh!
Though I bet you don't remember who dragged you out of the water. My name is Olga, by the way.
Hi.
Was it you fighting the master of the forest? Awesome. Our hunters had been staying away from him for years. Damn it. Sorry, teacher. The locks all rusted up.
She apologized for swearing.
Your friend Alyosha is already at the dam. He said your colonel won't wait, so you don't have much time.
Oh, you saved him too.
Sorry, I can't take you there. At today's council session, the pirates moved to attack your train. But they had no right to even call one without me present. As usual, I need to go and sort this out. But I have a few minutes to give you some directions.
Okay.
We need a boat to get to the dam. And our pirates keep all the boats at their swamp camp. They are not the sharing kind. But that's no reason to attack. Nobody wants bloodshed. So just stay out of their sight.
Easier said than done.
Go down to the swamp and find the dock. That's where Alyosha and I took the boat from. Teacher, forgive me. There are some left, but be careful. Well, Drifter, take care. And don't make me sorry I helped you people. Tell Alyosha I said hi.
Oh.
I'll stay a bit longer to tend to the grave of the teacher.
Oh, is that what this is? You made it seem like I can just jump down this way, but that doesn't seem viable. Oh, wait.
Decided to relax a bit before the trip. That's a good idea.
Wait, will you tell me things if I sit here?
And I'm stuck in thought here. Once the master decided to haunt the vicinity, people all but stopped coming here, though they haven't forgotten. The teacher raised us all, taught us how to survive in the forest. If not for him, we'd all be long dead. So the girls used to come here every day, and the boys still make it from time to time. Even Roman does visit, though it was because of him that the teacher left back then. Most of us went on a trip down the river. There were just a few people left on duty in the camp. When we came back, we found it raided by bandits. It still pains me to remember the scene. Can't even describe it.
Oh, so you're like the leader of the pacifist one, and I'm guessing that Roman guy's the leader of the,
The teacher was digging the graves in them. The elder boys were nowhere to be seen.
The pirates?
We helped the teacher with burying ours. It was dark already when the boys returned and sat around the campfire. Roman was so covered with blood, you could only see his eyes and teeth. Then
it's a grisly picture.
Tracking was easy. The bandits didn't even try covering their tracks. So the boys waited till they all got drunk in their camp and shot them with bows. Then Roman knifed the wounded like they were deer. The teacher just sat there listening. I can still see his chin trembling. And he didn't say anything. Anything at all. They understood what he meant anyway. Come morning, he was gone. To this church. At first, he wouldn't speak to anyone. But us girls kept checking up on him. Just to bring him some berries. Or ask for advice. And gradually, he started speaking to us. Till he was like a different man, so distant. He never talked to the older boys anymore, though he'd reply to their letters. And to the rest of us who'd keep visiting him, he would always say we had to become their conscience, keep them from becoming monsters. But how do you do that? And they didn't stop at that either. Started calling themselves pirates, made the flooded lumber mill in the swamp their private HQ. Then, they started hanging bandits from the posts, calling them musts. One day they took about 10 bandits alive and used them to test all the boys. Made them kill the bastards. None of ours could do it. And they all got called cowards for that, and then got ostracized. That's how the pioneers came to be.
That's an interesting backstory.
Of course, they all calmed down by now. They're talking to each other, at least. But back then, only Luda and I could speak for the teacher at the council meetings.
Is there more?
In the end, Luda and a few boys just couldn't take it anymore and left. I wonder if they found a better place to live. I still keep checking the radio, hoping to hear from them. The teacher hoped too, but that hope didn't last long. They left in July. And in September, he shot himself.
Oh.
That seemed to get through to Roman. He got calmer. Some of the elder guys went over to the pioneers. After all, the important thing is that we stay together. So now I have an important voice at the council. Cause I can kick ass if they don't listen. And not just because they're not supposed to hurt girls. A fair fight is a fair fight. Thing is, the only one I lost to in a fair fight was Roman. And even then, I gave him a blue eye he had to wear for a week. That earned his respect. The one I had the most trouble with was the Admiral. He was Roman's right-hand man. Wouldn't leave the lumber mill no matter what. Kept saying we must defend it if we don't want the mutants to eat the whole valley. But the radiation levels kept climbing there. Roman checked it with the counter himself.
The Admiral?
So at one council meeting, Roman and our instructors had everyone vote against the Admiral. And the pirates went on to build a new fort near the shore, where it's still okay to stay. The Admiral would have none of that. So he and his most hardcore flunkies stayed at the mill. I never heard from them again. Radiation's not to be played with. The teacher didn't...
How do we get to this subject? I just zoned out for a second.
So now, without the Admiral, there is nobody who dare give me any trouble in the Council. I'll put a leash on them tonight, all right. Don't you worry. I just need some time
oh,
to
it's
gather
a boat.
My thoughts. I don't like politics, really. You could listen to the teacher's diary if you like. He kept recording it. As if he knew.
Ooh.
Yes. I must have heard it 100 times already and still... We let him down. We really did.
Is your story done now? Okay. Oh yeah, look at that. I can listen to it now.
The radio's silent. My last hope for giving them a positive goal, leading them out of this forest dead end, was a complete fluke. Where did I go wrong? How could these great, talented, active, brave, honest, friendly children who would actively seek justice turn into monsters? Sure, I'm no Pestalozzi, but I did all I could. And even more, I gave them all, my soul, my life. And what did that result in? A society of shut-ins. Who only respect strength and are no less cruel than the bandits they fight. Yes, some of them kept their purity, shrugged off the bad influence, and ended up leaving. I gave them all the fuel I had. But how few they were. Most changed. Could it be that in this world that routinely changes even the harmless animals into nightmarish freaks, mankind simply has no future? What is there to hope for? What's the point of even going through the motions anymore?
Well,
at tonight's council session, I'm going to remind them all what the teacher thought in the
end. Oh, you were actually waiting for me to finish listening.
I'll give them a piece of my mind.
Wait, is that where... Wow.
Did the teacher save us all so that we could just attack people?
That's where we crashed on the train.
Defending ourselves is one thing, but attacking, they can't deny that, and we'll have to stand down. Those pirates. Oh, boys.
Speaking of standing down, how do I get down from here? Oh, probably with this here ladder. That was cool. It's pretty much what I expected. They were, like, athletic kids, and he was teaching them, and it got out of hand. Am I going the right way? Church. Okay, so I gotta go around the bend here. At least it's daytime now. I shouldn't have to worry about wolves and bears. Ooh, that's a nice tree. It is pretty when you're not freaking out about all the things that are trying to kill you. Okay, I think that's enough for this episode, though, so thanks for joining me. Come back, I'll the next F up real soon, but until then, bye.